Hey, Africa, tell me how you're doing. The show is for you. Guys, we haven't had a reality fashion show that involves the whole continent. So, I mean, what more can I say, actually? That's what Made in Africa is all about. It is so exciting to see all these people from around the continent, you know, being a part of such an amazing and riveting fashion show. We're not here only for television. We're here to ensure that whoever wins actually gets this platform. That platform being, I mean, can you imagine showcasing your collection at the space? So immediately once you win, that same collection that made you the winner will be showcased at the space, and I love that. So they won't be lost, they'll really be, you know, selling, so they'll be in the business of fashion, and that excites me more than anything.
So where's the sequence going?
Don't worry about that.
It's either gonna be a surprise or a nightmare.
I think it's a big miss.
I'm so sorry.
Is that tasteful?
Tasty, but definitely not tasteful.
They can expect to see quirky comments from me, but more importantly, a lot of mentorship. Sure, so these guys are really under pressure. I mean, they have to work under 2 days with certain themes and create garments that make sense at the same time, that are aesthetically pleasing to the eye, technically make sense, overall in terms of overall presentation also makes sense, and please, I guess, the judges, and that's very tough. But also, we just learned in terms of technique, how different we are, even as a continent, and that's what makes it interesting. Here, you're finding some people who are like, no,
I don't use a pattern.
I just see your body and then I create the garment. And that's what makes me so excited about having a show in the continent, with the whole continent, because you're learning techniques that you didn't know were there, or maybe unlearning certain things too, and making yourself proudly African and saying, that's why I'm African, because we do this way, we do things a certain way. It's great to celebrate Africa finally in this capacity. And of course, BET is the best platform to do it, because it always celebrates, you know, the continent, and also taking the continent to the world. So it's by Africans for Africans, this show is. I'm so excited about it. And also, and I think it's authentic, because I am a part of fashion too. So not only am I a host and yes, EP, but also it's something that people can believe in. People want authenticity now in television. They want to know that people genuinely want to be a part of the show. You know, that the host is really invested in the show. And that's why I chose to also be a part of such a show. I'd been offered quite a few fashion shows, television shows, and television shows in general, but this one stood up because it celebrates the continent, and that narrative excites me. I'm excited to do stuff in the continent too, so yeah, what a time to be alive. La la la, you vibe. Can I tell you the vibe? Why this excites me too? So we shot this in KZN, and of course, we partnered with KZN Youth Development. And that always makes it interesting, because emphasis on the youth. We are using young people in who were somewhat new to television production, especially on this scale. Teaching a lot of young people what production's about on this level was something else. We didn't have too many problems. I don't know, I had a bit of anxiety, because, you know, thinking like, wow, you know, a whole production with young people who essentially haven't been a part of any production like this is something else, but they did very well. Here's a platform that we're giving young people to be a part of such a beautiful narrative and story, you know, and shooting in a beautiful locations in KZN. Me being from KZN too was amazing. To go back home and shoot in KZN was something very different. I haven't done it in more than 10 years. My first show was when I was 15, my first television show, so I haven't done it in a long time. So it's good to be home and discover new places that I didn't know existed in Durban. It's interesting playing the dual role as being the host and being a part of production. A lot more stressful. You know, I just come and do my makeup and, hi, welcome to Made in Africa. My name is Nandi Madi, and now it's like, hey, who's what? Does everyone have catering? You good? Okay, you know, which was something else and different, and I learned a lot. And I love it. Then you get to appreciate what people do behind the scenes a lot more, which I already did, but you really get a sense of understanding a lot of decisions that are made beforehand and why call times are really early. Just a lot. You get to understand a lot, and I love that. And I think it's important to empower a lot of females too. So I'm fortunate enough that here I am relatively young. I'm dirty 30. So yeah, hey, young, youth league young, yeah, under 35. And the fact that I've been empowered to play on such roles, that I can be a host and a part of production, which was very important for me. And I hope I opened doors for a lot more young females willing to do that, and also just to escape the stereotype of pretty face. It's something I've been trying to escape for a very long time. So I hope this shows a lot of females that you can do more and be more. Now that I'm dirty 30, my style has definitely changed, and I'll tell you, comfort is definitely key. I was never into comfort, especially when you're a spring chicken. You can wear whatever you can. And now I just really want to be comfortable. Slippers work. Anything works. Something great about being 30 is that you understand that less is more, and genuinely so, and that's because you're comfortable in who you are and your skin. And that I appreciate. You know, I really love the fact that I feel beautiful with a lot less. Sometimes even just a lot less. But I'm joking. As a married woman, it's great just to appreciate your skin, you know, the skin you're in. And that's what I'm really enjoying now. Yeah. That's what colour's about. It's the fact that you're showcasing talents from our continent to the world. Yes, I'm creative director. Yes, it's my baby. Yes, I'm the founder. But I actually was inspired by the concept that Kanye West came up with. This is before he went really crazy. Donda. Where he wanted a platform where creatives could just play. And that's what colour's about, where it's African creatives being able to play, whether you're craftsmen, fashion designers, artists in every sense of the way. It's just for them to be able to express themselves and have the platform, because I feel like a lot of creators, all they need is just a platform. They have the talent, and that's what I can actually give to them. Yeah. What is the inspiration about behind color, rather? Color is everything. Color is life. Color is who we are. Color is the world. Color are your thoughts. Color is how you feel. You know, not every day is the same. You dream in color, you think in color. Life is colorful. So that was my inspiration, just life. And I'm so glad I thought of that name, because it also just opens up a world of creativity, you know, and we're working with a lot of amazing people. I can tell you an exclusive. I'm working with an amazing human being. His name is Omar. His label is Sukena. We're partnering up for color. He's currently doing a lot of garments for Naomi Campbell, actually, which is amazing. And she loves the continent too. And he just did something with Sandy Newton. And he lives in New York. So we're partnering up to showcase for New York Fashion Week, which is really exciting. The business of fashion perspective, I was just saying this earlier on to someone, where it's so important for you to have your own DNA when coming out with a fashion line. Your DNA, the name included, and actual garments. That's the most important thing. Where everyone knows when you want this, you go there for that. That's the most important thing. Otherwise, you'll be assimilated, you won't last, there won't be legacy. And then also to reinvent. And then also, sadly, to find ways where you can find sponsorship of sorts. You do need funding, and that's something I've learned a lot too. It's a lot of funding needed in fashion, and I think that's why a lot of people also don't last. So you need to understand the business of fashion before getting into it, because there's a definite business element to it and how you can recoup all your expenses. So I was reminded by an old friend of mine, Minnie, on my 30th. I've known her since I was 8 years old, and she reminded me that I used to sell these t-shirts in that land called Couples Clothing during my high school days, because you know high school, I mean, I was lucky, I wasn't into boys, but oh, teenagers and their hormones, and I said, let me make money off of this, all of this that's happening. So I made, they created a line called Couples Clothing, it was his and hers, they were t-shirts, and they did very, very well, and I remember telling Minnie, and she reminded me at my 30th, that I always said I want to showcase at New York Fashion Week. I'd actually forgotten about that. And it's funny how I'm Loma. Yeah, it's great to see how what you say can really, you know, come to fruition. And in my case, that was the truth. I'd actually even forgotten about that. And here I am with a lot of research, because I did take my time learning from a lot of people who I look up to in fashion, one of them being Noni Gaza. She's literally my sister. I took some advice, did some research, and yeah, then I was ready when I was ready, which was 2016. But then I was heavily pregnant, and I took a break do in 2017, because motherhood, as much as I thought would be just a kid and we'll do this easily, is something else. And of course, resumed in 2018 with my first show in New York Fashion Week, which is insane. Yeah. Fashion hits of all time. Okay, there's a couple. Just Egyptians. The whole era, the whole thing. Fashion hits of all time. The whole thing was amazing. That era was beautiful. But also, I think Miriam Makeba was a legendary. That drum cover magazine was just iconic. So that is a huge fashion hit. A huge fashion miss is us Africans trying to be something we're not. Miss. How do I balance it all? As you can see from my face, you don't. You take each day as it comes. And that's the truth. I think even if you're not a mom or not a wife or whatever the case may be, or don't have a business, you still have to balance. And that's just something you have to learn in life from the word go. You know, like my son, he likes to play, then he goes to play school, then he has to balance eating and playing. You know, he's also balancing. You cannot live with anxiety, you cannot be negative, you have to be positive, and you have to almost be able to bounce back from anything. So your attitude is the most important thing. So whatever comes to you, whether the task may be too big or too much to handle, or there's drama, if you stay positive, you know, make sure the noise is quiet and you stay focused on what you're supposed to achieve and the task at hand, then you can achieve what you need to. And if you don't, you pick yourself up, readjust yourself, see what you have to assess again, and continue. I've even learned it from my son, who is a toddler. Of course, at some point, he was trying to learn how to walk. And you know, he'd trip and fall, and we'd even laugh sometimes. But he didn't care. He knew that at the end of the day, I'm going to learn how to walk, and that's my focus. And I think if we all borrow that attitude from a lot of kids, we'd go far. Oh, what's up, beautiful people, my people. Make sure you catch Made in Africa on channel 129 BT with me.